In the book of Numbers,
if you can just go back.
In the book of Numbers, chapter 31, verse 17. Okay, I won't make this point, I'll go back to Jesus. Sir, Jesus, this was about killings, I was going to say, but I'll skip it, Jesus. Sir, last one, sir, in the book of Numbers, okay, you said to us that Jesus was worship. My question, sir, when we look in the gospel according to Matthew, when we look in the gospel according to Mark, when we look in the gospel according to Luke, when we look in the gospel according to John, it tells us Jesus, he bowed down, he prayed. Jesus, he looked up, he prayed. My question, if Jesus was God, and as you say that Jesus was worship, if Jesus was God, who did Jesus bow down to? Who did Jesus look up to? Who did Jesus pray to?
My friend, good question. But first of all, we've seen many, many scriptures that Jesus was worshipped. For example, what's his name at the end of the Gospel of John? What's the guy who said, "My Lord and my God"? Thomas.
Thomas,
at the end of the Gospel of John, said, "My Lord and my God," and Jesus did not say, "Don't worship me." So we have all these scriptures where people are worshipping him. The problem that you have as Muslims is you don't understand that we clearly believe that Jesus was a man, just like you.
So not God.
So we believe that. But we have these other scriptures, and we take all the scriptures together, and we hold them together, and it talks about he is God and he is man. For example, in the Gospel of Mark, it says, the Gospel according to the Jesus, the Son of God. Son of God title. At the end of the Gospel of Mark, when Jesus was crucified, they arrested him and put him on trial because of blasphemy, because they said he claimed to be God. And in John chapter 8, Jesus said, before Abraham was, I am. Now, your Quran, you believe that your Quran is eternal and became paper. We're saying Jesus was eternal but became a man. You're saying the word became paper. We're saying the eternal word Jesus became a man.
Was Jesus the son of? Sir,
I'll let you finish now and we're going to close it, yeah?
Okay, right.
So you have the last point.
Okay, thank you very much.
And then sir, we'll shake hands.
Okay. Sir, you said earlier on that Jesus is the Son of God. Sir, when we read, don't worry, I know the Bible as well. Sir, earlier on you said Jesus is the Son of God. But when we read your Bible, Gospel according to Matthew, Gospel according to Luke, when we read the genealogy of Jesus, it tells us Jesus, son of Joseph. Now, is that true?
I was going to let you finish. Do you want to continue?
Okay, let me tell you.
Of course it's true.
Jesus is the son of Joseph. Yes.
And the son of God.
How can? No. I know every baby in the world.
I'll explain to it.
They have one father and one mother. How can God have two fathers?
Let me explain, sir.
You said you were rusting. I didn't speak.
Let me answer, because okay, we need to shake hands when we finish.
I can speak. I can speak.
Son, he was adopted.
Okay, he's keen to speak. Let me speak. Shake hands. And till next week.
All right,
week after, Allah willing, we can debate again. Yes, sir.
Right.
Okay, yes.
Okay, this is the 99 days of Allah, yeah?
Yes.
It says Allah.
Jewish culture.
It says Allah. It says the first and the last.
Allah Awwal means the first.
Yeah.
Okay. Allah Akhir means the last.
Yeah, okay.
So Allah is the first,
okay.
Allah is the last.
Do you have a Bible? You know?
I have a Bible. Which Bible do you want?
Any.
When it means.
No.
What's why Isaiah 44 verse 6?
Pardon?
What's why Isaiah 44 verse 6?
Do you believe? Is that the Old Testament?
Yeah, just go to it. I'll show you. I'm going to make a point.
No, you're the Christian. Give me your Bible.
I'll show you. Just hold. Sorry.
All right.
Are you okay with that?
Yeah, sure.
I just want to ask a question on this. Okay, you go to the book of Isaiah. Verse 44, sorry, Isaiah 44, verse 6. There. It says, I am the first and I am the last. Besides me, there's no God.
Who said?
That's
Jesus.
That's the prophecy. Wait. So, in the book of Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah is a revealed prophecy. It says, I am the first and I am the last. Yeah? I'm not saying it's God. The 99 in Balak saying the same thing. Yeah? So, you go to the book of Revelation. Okay? That's the revelation of Jesus Christ. Okay. That's Revelation 1, verse 11. Jesus says, I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last.
Jesus is the first and last.
He says it in his own mouth. I'm the first and the last. The Quran, all 99 days of Allah, give the same title for God, the first and the last. The book of Isaiah says the same thing.
But Jesus also said, I was sent only to the Lordship of Israel. English is my second language.
Okay.
And when somebody says only,
do you understand?
He means only.
Do you know the history behind the history? Do you know the history of Israel? Do you know the context of the history of Israel?
No, come back to Jesus. You don't have to go to the history of
Israel. Let's go to the history of Israel. I want to deal with that.
Now, come back to talk about Jesus.
Now,
talk about Jesus. So Jesus was the baby son of Mary, yes?
Jesus was born into this world as a baby.
Was Jesus the baby son of Mary?
Yes, he was. We know that. We don't deny that.
Is God the baby son of Mary?
Not a baby.
Christian theology says this. Okay. Christians believe that God entered his own creation through the person of Jesus Christ. Okay. We believe in a God of miracles. We believe God can enter his own world through Christ and he can also come from heaven at the same time.
When Jesus was in the womb of Mary, what does that mean there was no God outside?
I've just answered that point.
You just said God is only one.
I said, you believe in the story of the burning bush with Moses. Is that correct? Okay. God was speaking to Moses through the flames of the bush. Where was God when he was doing it?
God is everywhere.
Exactly. That's my point.
Everywhere.
That's my point.
But God is not Jesus.
So God came down to earth through the person of Jesus Christ, and he can still come because he's a God of miracles.
So why
you don't believe in a God of miracles?
So why didn't,
I do.
Why didn't Jesus know the last hour? If Jesus was God, because God knows everything.
Well, the reason why.
Why?
The reason why he said that statement to the people at the time
was true.
Because he came to tell them of the good news of salvation.
So it was true.
So he said the last hour will be fulfilled by signs.
He doesn't know.
He said the last hour for the Lord to return.
Make it simple and we'll finish, yeah?
No
Make it simple and we will finish. Come back.